Welcome to our foam rolling video. So this video is going to show a little sequence you can do with the foam roller. First of all, I'm starting on the posterior side of the body and I've gone into the hamstring. So I'm putting the foam roller behind my hamstring and I'm rolling down from the top of the hamstring down towards the knee. Now the key thing to remember here, whenever you're foam rolling, you never roll across a joint. So you're only going to roll down from just underneath the origin to just above the insertion on any muscle you do. Don't roll over a joint. You're also always going to be rolling the muscle in the line of the fibers. So you can see by doing a hamstring, I started with a foam roller just underneath my glutes and I'm rolling down to just above my knee, but not on the joint. I start off with just a leg on the roller and I'm supporting myself with the upper body through my arms, and my other leg that I'm not rolling or that I have just finished rolling is now supporting the movement. To do this, you can control the pressure nicely. Now I can add pressure to this roll as I roll across the hamstring muscle by adding the leg that's not being massaged over the top of the other one. So now I've done that, I've got extra pressure going down onto that foam roller and increasing the pressure of the massage itself. So foam rolling is also known as myofascial release. It's a way to give self-massage. You can't beat going to a sports massage therapist and getting a proper in-depth massage by a professional, but this is a way that we can do it ourselves in a gym at home. After the hamstring, I've now gone down onto the gastrocnemius and the soleus, so the calf region. Again, note how I started just below the knee and I'm rolling down to just above the ankle. So I'm starting just below the origin of the muscles towards just the above the insertion, just above the Achilles. I'm rolling the whole length of the muscle, but note as you go through this video, I'm not always rolling the whole length of the muscle. Sometimes I find a tight spot, like there probably, I'm just hovering around that little area, putting more pressure onto that tight spot, onto that little trigger point, trying to release the pressure within the muscle. Obviously, you've always got to do both sides. So now I'm on the second leg on the calf region, rolling the length of the muscle down the line of the muscle fibers from just below origin to just above insertion, taking the body weight in my upper body and my supporting leg. Remember, I can always add that extra pressure by adding the leg on top, but always start with as least pressure as possible and slowly add the pressure as you go through the movement itself. Some individuals, yourselves included sometimes, or maybe your clients, if you're a personal trainer or fitness professional, may feel a bit of strain when you're holding your upper body through your wrists. Obviously, you've got to make sure it's as comfortable as possible. Now, from the hamstring region into the calf region, now we're going to go to the outer hip region. So the outer part, lateral part of the thigh. So this is rolling TFL, the tensor fascia latea muscle. I'm starting on the outside of the hip where that muscle has most of its blood supply and muscle fibers. As you work down the TFL, down the lateral side of the thigh, like I'm doing there, that's where it gets really painful. When that muscle goes quite tenderly as it goes towards the outer part, the outer knee. So your TFL will go into your IT band, your iliotibial tract. So it's a real tight part to, hard part to roll, this area. Painful. My suggestion would be to just stick around the outer hip and only try going down the lateral part of the thigh towards the part where it goes in towards that IT band. Just do it with care. I'm supporting the weight of my body with my upper body and the leg that's not being massaged. You can see that, so I'm controlling that pressure. But do this area with a lot of caution. If it's too painful, don't do it. A lot of individuals get problems from that IT band on the lateral part of the knee. Runners get that issues quite a lot, especially if you're running in using the incorrect trainers, not supportive. getting a little bit too much of an overstretch in that outer part of the knee. Anything that you're not sure about or anything that's really painful, especially with a bit of self-massage like this, if it's too painful, go and see a professional. Go and see a physio, osteopath, and get it treated. Sports massage therapist, get it treated by a professional. So that was a TFL muscle, the outer part of the thigh. Now to carry on with the lower body, I'm now on the anterior side. So I've done the posterior, hamstrings, calves, then the lateral side of the TFL, and now I'm going into the quadricep region. Again, starting just below the origin and rolling down towards the insertion, but not going over any joints. Rolling down the whole length of the muscle, taking my time, there's no rush with this one. I'm probably doing a little bit quicker than normal in terms of spending a set amount of time on each muscle just because I'm being filmed. If you're doing this on your own, try to always make sure that you're warm first. If you're going to do it at home, go for a walk around the block, walk the dog, after you run or whatever it may be, but get yourself warm, get the blood flow in the muscles, and then give yourself a nice roll. You can do this at home, do it on a hard floor. It's better than a bit of carpet normally, just because the roller doesn't sink into the carpet. But this is something that you can do in your own time. It doesn't have to be done in a gym. So just rolling around, make sure it's comfortable for you. The reason I'm flexing my knee there, it's just to change the movement of the muscle, change the position of the muscle, so I get into some deeper fibers as I do it as well. The key thing to remember here is that when you're rolling over a muscle, you're taking your time with it. If you find those tight spots, those trigger points, just hang around, add the pressure, just by keeping pressure on without moving anything, but just keeping the weight going through that pressure, that can help release it and break down any scar tissue. So I've now gone onto my glute region, rolling on the glutes and the deeper muscle, the piriformis, a really common one for a lot of individuals to have strained, especially runners again. The reason runners come up a lot in this is because, you know, with running, you can be doing a lot of mileage, sometimes on hard, compact flooring like concrete. Puts a lot of stress through the body. So to roll the glute region, you see what I'm doing there. So now I'm on my right side. So what I've done is I've sat on the foam roller. I've crossed the right leg over my left leg. I'm rolling on the right side. And I've put my body weight onto the right glute region. Taking the weight through my upper body, controlling the movement. And that pushes my weight through the roll itself. Gets into the deeper muscles of the glutes, into that piriformis a bit. Really good one to do that one. Now what I'm using here is a massage ball. Solid ball. Again, all this is gonna do is get a lot more deeper into the muscle, be a lot more specific on the area that you're rolling. Same technique. Now I'm rolling out on the left glute. So I've crossed my left leg over my right. Supporting through the upper body. And I'm just finding little pressure points. Extending my leg there just changes the focus on what I'm rolling. It's a really good one. A lot of individuals have tight glutes. Really important part of the body is to stretch as much as you can and roll as much as you can. Remember, rolling can be done anytime. Pre-workout, mid-workout, post-workout, around your workouts. Try to roll every day if you can. One thing we see a lot of on our courses, our personal training courses, is when we're teaching students how to use foam rollers, one of the first things they do, which is what I love to see, is they're off out buying themselves a foam roller and a massage ball. So I'm still using that massage ball, getting into the piriformis, that deep glute muscle. And I'm going back to the foam roller. Going on to the posterior side again, upper back. You can roll out your lower back, but do so with a lot of care. Adds a lot of pressure to that lumbar part of the spine or the vertebral column. So I'm just going on the upper back here, which is what I much prefer to do. If I go too low down on that vertebral column, I can feel too much pressure and I don't have as much control on the roller. So one thing you can see I'm doing, I'm moving around a lot. I'm trying to find those tight areas of the trapezius. Into the rhomboids as well. You can get your rhomboids by folding your arms across the front of your body like you'll see me do in a moment. Just moving around. Again, probably a bit quicker than what I normally would. If I wasn't being filmed, I'd spend a little bit longer in doing all of this. There we go, we're folding my arms across my body, retracting the shoulder girdle slightly, just to open up the muscle fibers. Moving around from one side to the other to get on the more dominant side, sometimes on the trapezius, get on the right side, roll around, focus on the right side only, and then go back to the left side. And this will be getting your latissimus dorsi as well. It's all about just moving around with this and having a little bit of a play. You'll see on that last roll as well, I was supporting my head a bit. So if you have a bit of a tight neck when you're doing this, just support your head with your hands. So what I'm doing now is I'm going into latissimus dorsi muscle specifically. And this is quite a painful one. You can see from the expression on my face, it's not very pleasant. I've extended the arm on the side that I'm rolling, palm facing away from me, facing forwards, facing the camera, and I've got my thumb stuck up in the air. And that's just gonna lengthen out those muscle fibers in my latissimus dorsi. I'm supporting myself. I paused there because I found a tight spot and I was just letting the pressure build. Try and break down the scar tissue.